Lord Jesus, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. What's amazing to me is this. The Apostle Paul is being used of God to write these words, and he was not present when Jesus instituted the Lord's Supper. He had received it by revelation. I'm here to tell you today, the Spirit of God can make this so real to you, it would be as though you were back there when Jesus instituted it. Because Paul received it by the Spirit. Let's read further, okay? And it tells us this. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." I just want us to take a moment here and get quiet before the Lord and close our eyes and see what the Spirit of God wants to do in each of us. Will you do that as we approach the table of the Lord? Certainly, we need to confess if there's something between us and the Lord. We need to take care of that. If we have problems with somebody who is a Christian that is present, then we need to ask forgiveness before we partake. But I want us right now just to wait for a moment in the presence of God. Can we do that? I'm here to tell you that not only will he cleanse us today, but he will heal our bodies if we are open to that. So let us just for a moment, okay? Wait on the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Dear Father, bless the people as they come today to partake of Holy Communion. We pray there be a time of cleansing for all of us, a time of healing of our bodies. And we give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. I'd like to ask the people today that are going to help us up here to serve, if they would come. Praise the Lord. I encourage you to come down the center aisle and you will be able to pick up the elements. And then if you go back to your seat, then could you use the outside aisles? But we encourage you to get around the altar. Also, I want to add this, is that we believe in getting into family units. If you don't have a family here today, go to someone else where you see them with their family unit. They will really welcome you. And please, all of you, be on the alert. If you see somebody by themselves, invite them over, okay? In Jesus' name.
Makes me
Can you say amen? Praise the Lord for the precious blood of Jesus. We're going to invite the Spirit of God right now together. Dear Spirit of God, here I am. Here we are. Come now. Touch our lives. Change us. Transform us. In the name of Jesus, we welcome you. We welcome you. We welcome you. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to your name. Glory to your name, Jesus. Glory to your name. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. We love you, Lord.
We welcome you in this place now. Come today afresh and anew. Fill us afresh and anew, fresh and anew. a curse of sin and shame I done, and death was overcome the day he came for me. And now I have a song to sing. I was lost, then Jesus, you found me. Now I live forever free. I was lost, and then Jesus, you found me. The cross, standing in my place. Every death was paid, I stand in victory. The curse of sin and shame I've done, and death was overcome the day he came for me. And now I have a song to sing. Oh, I was lost, then Jesus, you found me. Now I live forever free. Yes, I was lost, but then Jesus, you found me.
You're my God.
You are my God, and I will praise you, praise you. For all you've done, yes, I will praise you. You are my God, and I exalt you, exalt you. For all you've done, yes, I exalt you.
Sing that.
You are my God, and I will praise you, I'll praise you. For all you've done, yes, I will praise you, Jesus. You are my God, and I exalt you, exalt you. For all you've done, yes, I exalt you.
Now I have a song to call church. I was lost, and then Jesus, you found me.
Now I live forever free. I was lost, in Jesus you found me. Now I have a song to sing. Oh, I was lost, and then Jesus you found me. Now I live forever free. I was lost, in Jesus you found me. You are my God, and I will praise you, praise you. For all you've done, yes, I will praise you, Jesus. You are my God, and I exalt you, exalt you. For all you've done, yes, I exalt you. Cause now I have a song to sing. Yes, I was lost, and then Jesus, you found me. Now I live forever free. I was lost, now I have. Oh, I was lost, and then Jesus, you found me, and now I live forever free. Oh, I was lost,
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you that you have found me. Oh.
You're my hope and stay.
presence, God. We need your strength. God, we need your strength today. God, we cry out to you. Lord, strengthen us each and every step we take, God. May we be walking in your strength, God, not in our own. Help us, God. Help us to seek your face each and every day, God, afresh and anew, so that you can guide our footsteps, God, and give us your strength. Infuse us with your strength today, God.
Our hearts are yours, we want you.
we want you here. Come and consume God, oh we are.
We give you permission.
Hearts are yours, we want you. We want you. Come and consume
God,
oh we are.
We give you permission.
Hearts are yours, we want you. We want you.
Fall down,
so much. We can't get enough, 'cause we need you so much. We can't get enough, 'cause we need you so much. We can't get enough, 'cause we need you so much. We can't get enough, 'cause we need you so much. We can't get enough, and we need you so much. We love you. We'll never stop. We can't live without you, Jesus.
Praise you, Lord. You're so good to us. Thank God for His Spirit. Did you sense, even as we were singing in a quiet way, nothing against what we were doing earlier, but you just sense His presence just grab a hold of you, you know, surround you. Boy, you can't find that anywhere else in the world. How wonderful it really is. You may be seated. I'm going to ask the ushers to come. We want to receive the offering today, but also with that, we have some prayer concerns that we want to lift before the Lord. Listen up. This morning, I got a call from Stan Bork, and he told me that we need to really pray for him and the family, and that we needed to lift up Ryan because Ryan is really giving them a difficult time. He didn't want to go into any detail, but he just asked that the body of believers would pray. So let's lift that need up today. Harry Wirt, we're continuing to pray for him and believe God for complete and full healing. Pray for Casey, his wife, because she needs encouragement as well. Betty Ricewick, she's here today. We're thankful for that. We want to continue just to believe for her that God will just heal her completely. Can you say amen? Andrea Gunn, I don't see her here this morning, but she needs our prayers for healing as well. This morning I was talking to Matt Pryor, who had a bicycle accident. He commutes back and forth to work riding his bicycle. And because of the accident, he has 3 broken ribs, a broken collarbone. But he was telling me this morning, he was saying, I'm amazed. The pain isn't that great at all. So your prayers really have prevailed as you have prayed for him, you that have known about it, okay? So let's continue to believe for complete healing there. Anthony, we need to lift him up in prayer. Anthony, I know you've had these back spasms. We're just believing God for complete healing for you. And then we have a prayer request down here that I need to grab. Aaron Barnett requests prayer for this Thursday for her situation, okay? She didn't put any more on this prayer request than what I've read in your hearing, so I'm not sure she wants me to go into great detail, but I know it has to do with her going to court because of what happened to her life.
Hello, everybody. I got here late, but I promised my friend I would have the church pray for her. You might remember her. I'd bring her to the Christmas banquet. She was the one in the wheelchair. She's going to have surgery this week, Tuesday, at Hershey Medical Center. It's going to be an all-day surgery. They want to correct the process that she has right now of, you know, being in the wheelchair and all that involves. So it's going to be bladder, bowel, redoing, to put it nicely. but that's like this Tuesday at Hershey Medical Center. So just keep her in prayer. She said, ask the church to pray for me. Melissa Wilson. So thank you very much. God bless.
Praise the Lord. Also, a prayer request was presented to me during the worship time. Pastor Robert Monzone. Some of you know who he is and have sat under his ministry, okay? He fell and fractured his hip. He will need a hip replacement, and we need to lift him up in prayer today. Amen? And then finally, the fundraiser. We need to really pray that it be successful. Can you say amen?
Amen.
And so let's just believe God for that. How many can say that you know you're a believer priest today? Amen. That's something that was restored to the church under Martin Luther, the priesthood of the believer. Praise God, we don't have to go through a priest. We go through Jesus, our high priest, and talk to our Papa God. Amen? All right. Will you stretch your hand in this direction as one of these gentlemen will lead us in prayer?
Our Heavenly Father, you truly are an awesome God. The great and mighty things that you have done in the past and are doing even today just gives us confidence that you have the ability to heal every need that was mentioned this morning. And we trust that you will bring that healing. We would pray for more instant healings as we are hearing about these throughout the world. How greatly and powerfully you are working in so many areas of this world. It gives us confidence that we are in the last days, that a great and mighty thing will be taking place one of these days. Our Lord's return. Thank you for the unique things that you are allowing man to discover in your word. Even encoded messages. Isaiah has encoded the names of 12 disciples. Isaiah was written many years before they were even chosen. What a truly awesome God you are to have known who would be selected to be a disciple. It inspires us to trust you more and more. And that's just one tiny little aspect of the great things that you have revealed in your word. Even realizing that if you encode a message, every letter has to be exactly in place or it cannot work. How truly mighty you are, and your understanding is beyond our comprehension. We thank you and we praise you for it. And we just trust that you will bless each and every one as we bring our tithes and offerings into your house. We pray for a mighty blessing upon each one. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Apologize for that. I'm not sure the reason for it. If it bothered your ears, I want you to know it bothered mine as well. So we're in the same boat. I don't think it's going to sink. Amen. Praise the Lord. I want to recognize this morning, or at least say hello to everybody that's here for Tom and Lucy. Not only our current congregation, but there are people that have come today, some from far away, in order to be here today. And they do that because they honor Tom and Lucy and the years of ministry and how that they've been the recipients of God working through them to touch their lives. So that's awesome. So I just want to say to all of you, they're here today because of the dinner that's a fundraiser, and then the auction in order to help alleviate some of the financial needs they have. They have insurance, but it doesn't cover everything. How many know that? And so there's a lot that they need help with. So thank God that you're here today. I'd say this to you, Lucy. I have to watch myself because I might cry. To see you dance today for the first time in a while really meant a lot to me. And the real Lucy comes out through her dance. And you dance to the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. I don't know what's happened to me this week. I've really been challenged physically. And I want to thank everybody here for your prayers on my behalf in order to receive healing. I got hit with a flu that is unreal. And believe me, when you go from Sunday until Thursday before you eat much, that tells you that it's quite severe. But I'm standing before you today because of the Lord, because of your prayers and your love for me. So I do thank God for that. Amen? God is so good. He really, really is. Today I want to look at a psalm, Psalm 46. It's a psalm of triumph. This is a message for Tom and Lucy. This is a message for everybody here, I believe. It's a message to me. And so I'm going to ask you to stand. We're going to read the first three verses. And I want you to listen to it very, very carefully today, okay? It reads this way: God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear. Will you say, I will not fear? Will you say it again? Will you say it to the powers of darkness?
I will not fear.
Amen. Will you declare right now, I will not fear? Glory to God. Let's read on. Even though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though its waters roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with its swelling. Let's ask God's blessing as we fellowship around the Word for a while. Father, here we are. You know us by name. We thank you that you're our Papa God. We thank you that you know everything about us. We thank you for the acceptance that we have in the person of your Son. We thank you, O Lord, that you love us and care. And we thank you, Father, for Tom and Lucy. We're believing for complete healing for Tom. And so we ask even today that your resurrection life, your divine quickening, will be experienced in his body, the temple that you own, in a greater measure than ever before, in the name of Jesus. And we thank you for it. And everybody said, amen. You may be seated. What this psalm does for you and me today is that it encourages us to hope and trust in God. To trust in his power and his providence. How many believe God is really over all? Yes. How many believe he's got the whole world in his hands? Yes. He really, really does he not? And this psalm also encourages us to trust that his gracious presence will be on us and will surround us in the most difficult times that we find ourselves going through. And really what this psalm does is that it directs you and me to give him glory for all that he's done for us and all that he's about to do for us. I'd like us to think for a moment about the historical background of this particular psalm. This was written during the reign of King Jehoshaphat, when the enemies of Moab, Ammon, and Edom came against Israel. God did something there. God arose as their strength and help, and he brought about a supernatural intervention during this time of trouble. God wants to do that for you and me today. I want us to think about this psalm, Psalm 46, in early church history. This particular psalm was the psalm that really, really inspired the famous hymn written by Martin Luther in 1529, known as A Mighty Fortress Is Our God. How many have sung that particular song at one time or another, that hymn? A Mighty Fortress is our God. Well, Martin Luther was inspired by this particular psalm. And this particular hymn was translated into 153 languages, and it was called the Battle Hymn of the Reformation. In fact, they even etched this psalm on the tombstone of Luther, and it was sung at the funerals of martyrs during the Reformation. It is said that when Luther would receive any discouraging news, he would say, "Come, let us sing Psalm 46. That's pretty neat. He further said this about this psalm. He said, "We sing this psalm to the praise of God, because God is with us and powerfully and miraculously preserves and defends His church and His word against all the fanatical spirits, against the gates of hell, against the implacable hatred of the devil, and against all the assaults of the world, the flesh, and sin." That's pretty neat when you think about it. Let me just share with you part of the first verse of "A Mighty Fortress Is Your God." And then I want to share with you the whole of verse 2. Note, if you will, "A mighty fortress is our God, a bulwark never failing, our helper, He amidst the flood of moral ills prevailing." Now, you got to remember, this was written in German and then it's translated into English. So it certainly doesn't move or flow like you would like it to. Second verse. And though this world with devils filled should threaten to undo us, we will not fear, for God hath willed His truth to triumph through us. The prince of darkness grim, we tremble not for him. His rage we can endure, for lo, His doom is sure. One little word will fell him." Isn't that neat when you think about it today? I'd just like to share a prayer with you that I think will help you. And you can vicariously enter into this particular prayer. It goes like this: "Lord, I've set my eyes upon You when everything is being shaken." Some of you today are going through a very difficult time. It may be a financial difficulty. Some of you are experiencing some sickness. Some of you are having problems with relationships. Some of you today have wondered, "Where is God? Does He really care? Does He really love me? I've been praying and yet I do not see His intervention." Well, again, in this prayer, "I set my eyes upon You when everything is being shaken, when earth itself seems unstable, when kingdoms tremble and when nations are in confusion, when people are under anxiety. You, O God, are my refuge, a shelter in the storm, my strength, my ground of hope, my very present help in time of need. I rest in You and say to my soul, be still in God." Oh, hallelujah. How many believe He's really in control? No matter what you see in the political realm today, can I tell you something? And you're not going to like what I say. The people running for president act like little children too much of the time. Okay? I don't care what the guy that heads up North Korea thinks, and he can make all of his charges and everything else, how he's going to really be able to have missiles that can reach America with a nuclear warhead. All of these things that we hear that is happening, terrorism everywhere, Brussels, Belgium, and what's going on there. I want you to know something today. God is in charge. He's in charge. Be still in God. Trust Him. Can you say amen? Amen. And then we have Psalm 46 verses 1 through 3, which I've read in your hearing. And really what we see here is something that's so important. God is our refuge and strength. Let's think about refuge just for a little bit, okay? Look up here, because what is a refuge? It's a secure place to run in times of trouble, a place to resist attacks, and a place to be encouraged. Hide me, O Lord. Hide me now. hide me until the storm is past. Amen? You know, refuge speaks of the defensive or the external aspect of salvation. I'm here to tell you that God is your strong refuge. He's my strong refuge. Amen? Into which we can run, in which we can flee and be absolutely safe. Oh, praise God for that. Let me give you some scriptures that talk about him being our refuge today. 2 Samuel chapter 22 verse 3 says, "The God of my strength in whom I will trust, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold," and listen to this, "my refuge, my Savior, you save me from violence." Psalm 62 verse 8, "Trust in him at all times, you people. Pour out your heart before him." God is a refuge for us. I want to tell you the story of a little bird, okay? The story you hear so often, and I believe there are paintings concerning it, has to do with a tremendous or big storm, okay? I think Bernie would say it, a huge storm, okay? You didn't get that. And I'm not saying Bernie Sanders is anybody we should vote for, but he uses that word huge a lot, okay? And only in certainly his accent does it really stand out. But this is one of the stories about a little bird. It has to do with a rock that juts up from the ocean. And this huge storm comes. And you'll find that this little bird is in the cleft of the rock, and it's safe as the wind and the waves beat against that rock. How many have heard of that story at one time or another? Any of you out there? Maybe you've seen the painting. Well, it doesn't look like you have. But that's not the story I want to talk about. It has to do with a little bird, but guess what? There's a big bird of prey that is trying to kill the little bird. And so it comes to attack. And what is happening is this little bird is darting back and forth as this huge bird is trying to kill it. And guess what? This little bird flew to save its life, and it quickly flew into a crevice and a rock face inside the cleft of the rock. The larger bird gave up. The little bird had found shelter in the rock. Its life was saved. How are we like that little bird? How many know that Jesus is the rock of our salvation? Amen? We can hide in him. We really can. But so often in the midst of the storm, we forget that. And so we find ourselves so vulnerable to the attack and the storm. Well, he's not only our refuge, but he's our strength. I want you to look up here when we talk about strength. When we talk about the Lord being our strength, we're talking about our unfailing source of strength that holds us up when we're weak and beat down. How many can say amen today? Pastor, I really need some strength. Are you out there at all? Well, I want you to know he's your strength, okay? If you look up here further, it says, God is our strength, refers to his being the all-sufficient one. Now think about this, all-sufficient one. You gotta say that slowly and think about all-sufficient one. And it speaks of the dynamic aspect of God within. Look at that word dynamic. Because when we look at the New Testament and find the word power, we have dunamis. And dunamis is where we get at least part of the word dynamite, dynamo, dynamics. Thank God that he does that for us. Where? On the inside, right where it counts. You know, when you think about the Holy Spirit, not only being called alongside to help you, but he's inside, right where it counts, so you can face life and you can look at it eyeball to eyeball and you're not going to run from it. Because you're going to stand for the glory of God. Amen? Let me just read some passages of Scripture that will speak to your heart, I believe, about him being our strength. Exodus 15:2. By the way, the chapter that I'm talking about here, Exodus 15, really is a song of deliverance. God has brought the nation of Israel out of Egypt, through the Red Sea, and they get on the other side, and guess what? Pharaoh's been right on their tail, or right on their heels. And all of a sudden the Red Sea closes and destroys them, and they're free at last from being slaves. How many are glad that you're not a slave anymore? We didn't sing that song this morning, but thank God that we're not, amen? Well, guess what? They sang a song. They got all happy, just like you did this morning. Exodus 15:2 says, "The Lord is my strength and song. He has become my salvation. He is my God, and I will praise Him." Psalm 28, verse 7, "The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusted in Him, and I am helped. Therefore, my heart greatly rejoices, and with my song I will praise Him." Can I tell you something? God wants to give some of you a new song this morning. That old song doesn't work anymore. He wants to give you a new song that will come from within. Why? Because He is your strength. He is your refuge. Praise God for that. Amen. Listen to Psalm 138, verse 3. "In the day when I cried out, You answered me and made me bold." How? "Which strengthened my soul." That's pretty neat when you think about it. Now, God is your present help. God is my present help. I just want you to see what it says here again in the scripture that we read today. So let's look at Psalm 46, verses 1 and 2 again. "God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble." How many heard that? Present. Say the word present. Present help. In trouble. "Therefore, we will not fear." Okay? So our God supplies for all of us what is needed to triumph in all of our trouble. Hallelujah. And God is the one that brings us through. And how does He do it? With two things. He's our refuge and He's our strength. That is great when you think about it. Now, I want you to notice, if you will, because in verse 2 and 3, it talks about what's going to happen to this earth. If the earth should change and undergo a total transformation, as seen in the language of verses 2 and 3, which to me speaks of what it says in Hebrews, okay, where everything that can be shaken will be shaken. So only that which cannot be shaken will remain. He's telling us, don't fear. Don't fear. Amen. You can trust God in the dark just like you can trust Him in the light. Psalm 91 verse 15 says, "He shall call upon me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him." I don't know how many of you know of this person. I think she's in heaven. I believe she is. She's written a book called The Helper. If you've never read it, you need to get it. All right. Catherine Marshall. She was the wife of her husband, Peter Marshall. He used to be the chaplain of the U.S. Senate. Okay. I'll tell you what, you need to get that book, The Helper, by her. But anyway, this is what she says. "Crisis brings us face to face with our inadequacy. And our inadequacy in turn leads us to the inexhaustible sufficiency of God." That's what happens. Can you say amen? Now, another scripture for you. Psalm 46, verses 5 through 7. "God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her just at the break of dawn. The nations raged. The kingdoms were moved. He uttered His voice. The earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge." Notice what this passage of Scripture teaches us up here. Number one, God is in the middle of our life and all our circumstances. Can I tell you what happens When we find ourselves in adversity, we forget that. Let's be honest. Too often we forget the fact that God is in it with us. One time I was going through such a difficult time. And I said to God something that I'm not going to say to you, okay? And you know what he said? He says, I know. And when he said, I know, I knew he meant because I'm there with you. Hallelujah. I'm going through the same thing you're going through, but I'm helping you. I'm strengthening you. I am your refuge, and I'm teaching you something that will help you to be a better person and to be a better servant and a better communicator and a better channel of my divine life. Praise God. Look up here. 2, we shall not be moved. We will not be tossed about. We will not lose our footing. We will not slip. And we will not be shaken. And then notice, God will help us right early. And literally what that means is turn of morning, or the critical breakground moment when night changes to day. How many of you have gone through a night and you said, I can't wait for morning? Have you ever been there? You might have been ill, or you might have been worrying. You might have said, boy, my body just won't relax. I just can't wait for morning. You know, there's something about morning. And I'm telling you, in a spiritual sense, that's what God wants to do. Hallelujah. He wants to give you breakthrough. Glory be to God. And I'm believing God for breakthrough, even this afternoon, in a financial way, for the Evanses. I'm believing God for that, and I trust that you are as well. But what about you today? Where are you? Okay, let's get by all the spiritual stuff, okay? I'm for spiritual stuff. That isn't what, I mean, you ask some people how they are, and they won't tell you. Sometimes we think that we've got to be a certain way. But what about you today? Where are you? Do you need God's help? If you do, stand up right where you are. I'm going to ask you to do something. Boy, there's a lot of you out there. Now, I'll be misunderstood because I said all that spiritual stuff. That I'm talking about, I believe in positive confession. I believe in those things. But I find that sometimes we're just not real. And we're afraid to say, will you pray for me? I really need your help. I need the help of the body of Christ because I'm going through a crisis. I'm going through such a difficult time in my life. And I need that help. Now I'll look back there and see all you standing. I'm going to ask you to step out. Now some of you are going to say, I don't want to come up here. I'm going to ask you to come anyhow. I'm going to ask you to get out of your comfort zone. Don't worry, I'm not going to embarrass you. We just need God's help. And you know, sometimes you can stand or kneel, but we've just got to open our lives to Him. We've got to open our lives to God. He loves you. I love you. The leadership loves you. We love you. We really, really do. Oh, in the name of Jesus right now, I want to bless what you're doing in these lives. I want to bless for you right now for touching people. And now I'm asking for a deeper work. You touch us in order that we can open our lives to you in a greater measure. And I'm asking in the name of Jesus right now that you touch each life here. That there be a change, an interchange that takes place in the name of Jesus even now. Lord, I pray that you show us and that you illuminate our mind and you put down deep in our spirit that you are our refuge and that you are our strength and that you will protect us. And even though everything around us seems to be chaotic and seems like it's falling apart, you're there with me. Hallelujah. I'm not alone. We're going through it together. Oh, praise God. So, Father, I pray for people that have come up that need healing, healed by your presence. Oh, and oh, yamandunde shikatataya. Oh, the Lord would say, my spirit is here to touch your life and to do something down deep inside of you that's never been done, the Lord would say. We'll open your life right now. I'm here. I'm here, saith the Lord. I'm here to do something that will change you forever. Open yourself up, the Lord would say. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for breakthrough. Breakthrough. Glory to God. Grab hold of breakthrough. Grab hold of it in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, for your glory. Grab hold of it today. Glory to God. Glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus. Oh, yeah, yes, Lord. I know you want to touch life. I know you want to do something. Oh, yeah. Jesus' name. Touch her, Lord. Minister to her. Do the work. Oh, yeah. Do the work in Jesus' name. Touch your Father. Hallelujah. I believe in Jesus' name. Glory to God. Minister by your power. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord. Do it in Jesus' name. Do it for your glory.